In this video, we're going to be talking about solving equations that are reducible to quadratic equations. We saw some problems that were like this in sections 5.7. That was a section on special factoring. We also saw equations like this in sections 6.6 and 7.4. And those sections were on rational equations and radical equations. What we mean by reducible to quadratic is that you have an equation that you're solving and then it ends up becoming a quadratic. So we saw enough examples of those in 6.6 and 7.4, but in 5.7, when we saw these types of equations, we really only looked at how to factor them. We didn't look at how to solve any of those equations, so we're going to look at solving some of them now. So if we remember, and again this is from section 5.7, an equation is in quadratic form if it can be written in the form AU squared plus BU plus C is equal to 0. So for example, if we had something like 10x to the 4th plus 11x squared plus 9 is equal to 0, this would be an example of an equation that's in quadratic form because it can be written like this. In this case, our u would be equal to x squared. We can solve equations in quadratic form by factoring, completing the square, or by using the quadratic formula. We'll also see an example where we can solve it with a combination of factoring and taking square roots. Here's one example. Let's say we want to solve the equation x to the 4th minus 16 is equal to 0. So we might notice that this is in quadratic form. We could express this as x squared squared minus 4 squared. And now we have difference of perfect squares. Remember, a squared minus b squared is factorable into a plus b times a minus b. And that's how we're going to factor this. So this is factorable into x squared minus 4 times x squared plus 4. Now, x squared plus 4 is not factorable. We can't do anything else here. But x squared minus 4, we can factor this using difference of perfect squares again, because x squared is a square and 4 is 2 squared. So this is going to factor into x plus 2 times x minus 2, and this is equal to 0. And now that we factor this as much as we can solve for x. So here we see x plus 2 has to equal 0, so x could be equal to negative 2. Here we see x minus 2 is equal to 0, so x could be equal to positive 2. And here we have x squared plus 4 is equal to 0. We'd end up with x squared is equal to negative 4. We're not going to get any real solutions out of this, so we're going to ignore this part, and we have our solutions are x is equal to negative 2 and x is equal to positive 2. Here's another example. This is in quadratic form. Here u would be equal to x squared again, because we could write this equation as 6 times x squared squared minus 10 x squared is equal to 0. The easiest way, I think, to solve this one would be by factoring. We can factor out a common factor of 2x squared. And the reason we're doing this is because there's no constant term. If there was a constant term, we might have to factor this a little bit differently. And then this becomes 3x squared minus 5, and that product's equal to 0. Now from here, we can't factor this any further, and at this point, we can begin solving for x. So the first factor we have over here, we can set 2x squared equal to 0, and this is just going to tell us x has to be equal to 0. There's no other solutions we can get out of this. And then from this factor, we see 3x squared minus 5 is equal to 0. So we see x squared is equal to 5/3, and at this point we could solve this equation by taking square roots or using the square root property. So we take the square root of both sides, we remember to include the plus minus, and we see here that x is equal to positive and negative square root of 5/3. So our solutions are x is equal to 0, x is equal to positive square root of 5 over 3, and x is equal to the negative square root of 5 over 3. Here's one more example. I would suggest pausing the video, try to work through this one on your own, then hit play to see me go through the full solution. In order to solve this, we would want to move this negative 9 over, have this set equal to 0 first. So if you wanted to solve this using completing the square, you could leave it as is. If you want to use the quadratic formula, or if you want to try to solve it by factoring, you would need to take this step here. Now that we have it in this step, we can say u is equal to x squared, and we can rewrite this as u squared minus 10u plus 9 is equal to 0, and this is factorable. Our ac would be equal to positive 9, and two factors of positive 9 that add to negative 10 would be negative 9 and negative 1. So this is going to factor into u minus 9 times u minus 1. But remember, u is equal to x squared, so we're going to change this back to x squared minus 9 times x squared minus 1. And now these two factors can be factored again. They're both difference of perfect squares. 9 is a perfect square, and 1 is a perfect square. So x squared minus 9 will factor into x plus 3 times x minus 3. And x squared minus 1 will factor into x plus 1 times x minus 1. And remember, this was equal to 0 the whole time. Now that we factored this as much as we possibly can, we can solve for x. So we see x is equal to negative 3, x is equal to positive 3, x is equal to negative 1, and x is equal to positive 1. So we have four solutions.